Let's learn the mechanisms of the serratiopeptidase. Firstly, before we understand the mechanism, we must know that serratiopeptidase is a metallolysis proteinase, which is a protease enzyme whose catalytic mechanism involves a metal, and its molecule weight range from the 45,000 to 60,000 kilodaltons and consists of 470 amino acids, which are important for its proteolytic activity. For the serratiopeptidase, the modes of action consists of zinc ion and bradykinins. So let's go through one by one. Serratiopeptidase have bivalent cations like zinc and calcium as essential cofactors within their structures. However, only a catalytic zinc ion that is located in the N-terminal proteolytic domains is essential for its enzyme activity. Another 7 calcium ion in the C-terminal is not essential for its enzyme activity, but it is necessary to protect it from the autolysis. So what is autolysis? It may sound similar to apoptosis, but they are different. Autolysis is a process for destructing an organism's cells by enzyme produced by the organism itself. Meanwhile, the apoptosis is a process of programmed cell death which occurs while an order sequence of events during the growth and the development of the organism. So the active site of the serratiopeptidase is contain a zinc atom bound to 3 histidine group, 1 tyrosine group, 1 methionine group, 1 glutamine group, and also 1 water molecule. So this active site is used to hydrolyze the non-terminal peptide linkage of polypeptide. Next, bradykinin is a peptide that promotes inflammation. It causes the enlargement of the arterioles. It also functions as the pain signaling. So this is a substrate with the chemical structures as that carbon in the gray color, oxygen in red, and the nitrogen in blue color. So let's pass to Yasmin to explain about the mode of the reaction.
Now, let's proceed with the reaction. The catalytic mechanism is hypothesized to be hydrolysis of internal alpha peptide bonds in a polypeptide chain by a mechanism in which water acts as a nucleophile. A metal ion holds the water molecule in place and charged amino acid side chains are ligands for the metal ions. The enzyme binds between proline and phenylalanine amino acids and cleaves it into two products, and bradykinin loses its function. So that is all in the reaction. Serratiopeptidase is showing broad substrate specificity. It can cleave the peptides with linkages of asparagine with glutamine, histamine with leucine, lysine with alanine, alanine with leucine, tyrosine with leucine, glycine with lysine, phenylalanine with tyrosine, tyrosine with tronine, tyrosine with tyrosine, arginine with glycine, and as well as cystic acid with glycine. Last but not least, the condition required by serratiopeptidase to perform maximal activity is at pH 9, and at temperature 40 degrees Celsius. It is stable in a wide range of pH, from pH 3 to pH 10, where it shows stable secondary structure. Meanwhile, it is completely inactivated by heating at 55 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. Tira, I hope you understand the explanation.